Damn, son, where'd you find this?
So now, 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 come sit down, will you talk with me now and let me see through your eyes where there is so much life. We are biding our time for these myths to unwind, with these changes we will confront. So please beware with every place that you head, and look to your soul for these things that you know. For the trees that we see cannot forever breathe with the changes they will confront. You know, some people just won't understand, won't understand, they say. Thank you for your message, but I don't understand, I just won't understand, they say. So hold nice and close, won't you get to your soul now? Born in this age, and I feel so alone, cause I feel innocent. Care to know all the changes it will conform. So speak out loud all the things you are proud of. If you love this coast, then keep it clean as it holds. Cause the way that it shines may just dwindle with time, with the changes it will conform. You know, some people just won't understand, just won't understand these things. Thank you for your message, but I don't understand, I just won't understand these things. You know, some people they just won't understand, I just won't understand these things. Thank you for your message, but I don't understand, I just won't understand these things.
What inspired you to play all the instruments you do play?
Since I was a kid, I always liked to just fiddle with things and teach myself to play stuff. And I've always had a real fascination with wood. I love wood and everything that I use is wooden.
I just wanted to know, what's your favourite NRL and AFL team?
I liked St Kilda when I was a kid. And I was a fan of Tony Lockett and Nicky Winmar.
I've got a question for you, Xavier. What is your Aboriginal name, and what does it mean, and where does it come from?
I was adopted into a family up in Nhulunbuy by my brother Milkay, who's a famous Yidaki player from Yothu Indi, and he gave me a name which was Mana, which means shark.
What's the difference between the three didges that you had up there?
They're all different keys, so because I play with guitars and things, they have to be in tune. So we pretty much tune the guitars to the didges, but depending on the length or the obscurity of it, the key will be different. So I think the ones I had there was D and E and G.
Can you just give us a brief on how you got so in touch with the Aboriginal culture?
I don't know how in touch I am, or I guess I've just felt something strong since I was a kid. And
can I answer this one for you?
Yeah, I'm going to hand this over to Jace.
He's just a black fella and a white fella's rapping, sir.
Thank you.
Well, here we are getting up close with Mr. Xavier Rudd. He's just come off the stage from the Live and Local sessions. How are you, my friend?
Good, brother. How are you doing?
Good. Very, very well. Man, it's a really, really beautiful gig, dude. Did you have a good time?
Yeah, it was special.
How do you approach playing a gig like that as opposed to playing like a big festival gig like you, man?
No real different approach, you know. It's just sort of each gig unfolds itself. I'm sort of the one channeling the energy. But quite often it's people who come along and each place that bring their journey.
And some of your instruments up on stage, they have a beautiful arrangement of these, of the wood and cymbals and all these sort of things. You have this fascination with wood, man.
Yeah.
Tell me, whereabouts did this come from?
I don't know. My grandpa made me an Aztec box that I have on stage. I think I got it probably from him, you know, and I've always loved wood. And then expressing myself musically, I find that using wood, the wood has its own expression, and it's kind of nice to use exotic wood, wood that has a history right back to the tree, and you know, because it sort of tells its own story in a way. You know, some people they just won't understand,
won't understand these things. Now, man, some of the tunes, the messages. Who was this tune written to or about, if you don't mind me asking?
Messages? Written basically about the spirit that I feel in this country. It's got a strong spirit. It's been going for thousands and thousands of years, and from a culture that really cared for the land. And Messages is sort of written from a space of wanting to preserve that spirit and have our kids and our kids' kids and our kids' kids' kids and so on feel that spirit and feel what we're so lucky to feel.
Well, guys, if you want to get up close and personal with your favourite artist, all you've got to do is register at coca-cola.com.au and you can experience this beautiful live setting, experience music the way it should be. Thank you, Mr. Xavier Rudd, once again.
Thanks, brother.
For what the each believe, well, on and on and on we go. Well, some will you see and some won't be true. For you and truth will lead you to a sense of hope. Well, now, please, so let me be now, let me be cause I want to be free now. Mr. Michael Franti.
Are you feeling
so fine?
If I could be the sun, I radiate like Africa. Smile upon the world,
in a galactic love laughter. And if I could be the trees, I would bring shade like evergreen. If I could be the leaves, I'd soak in the most sunshine I could feel. If I could be the earth, I'd be like mountains bountiful. And if I were the sky so high, I'd be like wind invincible. And if I could be the earth, I would bring you love all the time. And while we're out here at Byron Bay, I'll just be soaking up the sunshine. I wanna be. Just sit here now while Xavier.
Oh, baby, you wanna see, would you let me go?
I wanna be free now. Let me be. You're feeling the love this way because it's Xavier's on the guitar, stopping the drums, I'm on the mic, and I'm having fun. Yes, give me a little harmonica song now, son. Come on. I want to be
for the magician, Mr. Michael Fanti.
Son, where'd you find this?